Jesus. getting baptized during this holy mass at the very beginning, I just anointed him on the chest and did a prayer of exorcism. As the oil of the catechumen is preparing him to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And actually, at the beginning of every mass, we do something similar, asking God to forgive us of our sins and prepare us to receive him. And so we say, Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all in the world, and all passed through the sea, and all of them were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea. All ate the same spiritual food, all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank one spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was the Christ. Yet God was not pleased with those who come, for they were struck down in the desert. These things happened as examples for us, so that we might not desire evil things as they did. Do not grumble as some of them did, and suffer death by destroyer. These things happened to them as an example, and they have been written down and given to us. Upon whom the end of the age has come. Therefore, whoever thinks he is standing secure should take care of not to fall.
Considering where we are with God in our own lives. being open to hearing His will for us, paying attention in prayer. So the parable about the fig tree is that we are the fig tree, and are we bearing fruit? We may need to be watered with the gifts of the sacraments. We may need to be fertilized with His body and blood, cultivating bits of air around our roots through the practice of daily prayer and reading Scripture. It is only then that we come to understand the will of God. And then God watches to see what we're going to do about it. Are we going to bear fruit? Are we going to be people of action to care for our neighbor, to try to overcome our faults and sins, to be service to others, to help our family? Like these good parents today who are bringing their son to be baptized. But this is just the beginning. After baptism, their job isn't over, it's just beginning. Because then it is to raise your son in the practice of the faith. And you'll notice, as we do this ritual of baptism now, parents and godparents are challenged to raise their child in the practice of the faith. That's that gardener taking care of the tree so it bears fruit. So that as Nico Joseph grows up, he comes to know Jesus in his own life and receives the sacrament of reconciliation, as those names on that little board over there did this week. Our little ones who receive first reconciliation in preparation for First Holy Communion. It's called first because there's supposed to be many to follow. So that we can live our lives in service to God and bear fruit. And so I invite Nico Joseph's parents and godparents to please come over to the font. And I'll explain this baptism as we go, because it's very important to understand our baptism. You see all the signs and symbols of baptism again when we celebrate funeral. But because we are baptized, we live forever. So if you stand right here, all four of your friends are all, and big brother, okay, so to say, parents and godparents and big brother, you've come to present your son to baptism by water and Holy Spirit. He is to receive eternal life from God who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring him up in the practices of faith. See to it that the divine life, which God gives him today, is kept free from the poison of sin and always grows stronger in his heart. So if your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now your own baptismal promises when you rejected sin and Satan and profess your faith in Jesus Christ, the faith into which your son will be baptized. So let all of us stand and renew our baptismal promises. Do the reject Satan.
Thank you.
Nico, Joseph, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Okay, he said.
Very good. Very good. I really like that second name. Now I'm going to lay you a crown on the head. This is actually the christening part of the ceremony because the name with this perfume oil called the sacred chrism, and I'm going to anoint him in five places on the crown of his head for the five wounds of Jesus by which we're saved. So God the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you, Nico, Joseph, from sin, and given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit. Now he anoints you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was going to priest, prophet, and king, so may you always live as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. So Nico is now an anointed of the Lord, another Christ. St. Paul tells us in baptism we put on Christ, we are clothed in Christ. And so I present to him this white cloth, which has the Cairo on it, first and last letters of Christ's name in Greek. And I say, Nico, you'll become a new creation, and you'll clothe yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity, with family and friends to help you bring it unstained into the kingdom of everlasting life. Now that white cloth, we see again, as we did at this funeral we had this morning here. It is the white pall placed over the casket. And people are reminded, when this person was baptized, they were clothed in Christ. Now may they be clothed in eternal glory. It's also the reason we always wear a white towel under our vestments. Because as a Christian, we are to be clothed in Christ. The candle behind them is the Easter candle or the Paschal candle. The candle that symbolizes Jesus as the light of the world, the light that scatters all darkness. This candle has been lit many, many times because of so many funerals. We light it at the funeral, reminding the family this person was baptized. That's the first time that candle was lit. Now, I ask the godparents to light this candle from the Easter candle right behind you. And we say, parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you and you kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ, and there will always walk as a child of the light, so that when Christ comes, they may go out to meet him with all the heavenly hosts. Now, if you look at that candle, you can keep it lit inside the protection of the church. But the minute you walk outside, especially today, you're going to have a hard time keeping that candle lit. Because the winds of the world are going to snuff it out. And that's true for the faith that your son just received. He's going to look to you to protect it and to nurture it and strengthen him as he grows older like his big brother. Now, I'm going to touch his ears and his lips as Christ allowed the deaf to hear and mute to speak. So may he touch your ears, Nico, Joseph, that you might hear God's word, and your lips, that you might proclaim. Now it is my joy to introduce to all of you our newest Christian, Nico Joseph. Heavenly Father, we ask your blessings upon this family and the great gift of eternal life you bestowed upon their sons. We ask that you keep them protected from the evil one and allow their faith to grow in their hearts day by day. Enrich them always by your grace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
With joy and gratitude, let us all stand. are giving your children a sacred time for the removing and purifying of their hearts, that free from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of the passing world, so as to cling to those things that are eternally enduring. And so with all the angels and saints, we raise our voices in the song of your praise as we acclaim.
Where we too will
joining me in the blessed holy coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in history may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I am praying for God's blessing. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, that in your kingdom grant your